Clarissa here on Clarissa Says, or Clarissa Says It All, and that is how I feel. So today we're going to talk about the worst U.S. shooting in the history. Stephen Paddock, he did this at a Las Vegas concert at the Mandalay Bay Hotel in Las Vegas. Now, this man lived in Mesquite, Mesquite, Nevada, and literally he just, I guess, went to the 32nd floor with about 10 to 30 guns, because at first it said 10 on one of the CBS news reports, and there was another report that I seen, it was like 30, and you know that, you know, the media is fake sometimes, so they put things to catch your eye. So, but what I do know for a fact is he did kill about 58 to 59 people, and over 515 to 527 people were injured from being either hit by the rifles that he was shooting, or from being trampled over in like a stampede of humans that were trying to run away and not get hit by the gun that he was shooting from the 32nd floor. Now, for him to have so many guns, I don't know if he switched guns, but I do know that he let out about three magazines or more, because it was three times that I think I remember hearing him actually like reload. Like, it was like boom, 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 reload, boom, 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 reload, boom, 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 boom. And I think on the last time he was reloading, I think he was going to shoot, but that's when they came in and actually got him. Now, I'm kind of confused about the timing of this video, because there's things, actual videos that came out at around like 10 o'clock in the evening, and then at about 3 to 3:30, that's when this officially ended. So the entire time is like, for me, it's like this man was literally shooting from the 32nd floor, and no one was actually moving towards fighting this guy. And if you see the video of like people in the hotel, like the actual cops in the hotel on the 31st floor, they look kind of like normal. Like, they just look like they're standing there like no care, and I'm like, there's a man shooting from the 32nd floor on civilians at a concert that had 22,000 plus people, up to 40,000 on some of the articles that I've seen, and 30,000 on others. 22,000 first one I've seen, first thing in the morning on October 2nd. So from the time of October 2nd the morning to the end of the night, it went from 22,000 to about 40 to 30,000 people that were actually there at this event. Today is October the 3rd. And literally no one on October the 1st like got wind that he was from the 32nd floor. I mean, even in the videos, you can see people are literally pointing their camera at the actual Mandalay Bay Hotel. So someone, you know, was there, and it took them a little while to actually go and get that person. Maybe they need to go ahead and get the right people, the right crew of people, to actually the right skilled, trained type of people to go for this kind of a mission, this kind of a distraction that has been put out into the universe. But it took them a while. So from the time that he started shooting to the time that he ended, 59 dead people died, and about 527 people were actually injured in this chaos. So this man named Stephen Paddock, that had no military history, no military experience, he didn't even go to the army or anything like that. He did work at Lockheed Martin. So there are speculations saying that he was MK Ultra. If you guys remember Dylan, I forget his first name, but I know his last name is Dylan, or at least his first name maybe Dylan. There was a little boy that went and shot up a church in South Carolina a while back, and he, I believe, was MK Ultra as well. Now, people will say, well, everybody, whenever there's a situation that happens and it's a mass shooting, and I'm sorry to put race in it, and it's a Caucasian or a white, everybody always says MK Ultra. Everybody always say that it is MK Ultra, that they didn't really do it. But when it comes out to black people, they did it. It's them. They don't care. People don't give them a benefit of the doubt that it wasn't their true actions. It was them. Okay. I feel y'all, but I feel as though black or white doesn't make a difference. People are human, and no one's gonna go and do something that crazy. Even with the Stephen thing, I told y'all, if y'all haven't seen the video, please check it out. It was a hoax. He did not do that. He didn't kill anybody. He didn't kill that old man. It was a hoax, complete hoax. And I feel as though with this kind of situation, the government has to do certain things to promote the actions that they want. They are trying to control the guns. So I'm going to show the public as much stuff as I can, like, to scare them into doing what I want them to do when the time comes. So is it going to come now? Maybe in 2019, because I think 2019 is a big year for us. So look out for it. But this is definitely something to actually be used as an example for gun control when the time comes. So they're trying to promote gun control. They're trying to promote fear mongering to people that don't have strong minds. A lot of people that are living in America don't have strong minds because we're sheep. We are taught to be meek like sheep and to follow what the government says. We need the government, blah, blah, blah. But we forget the fact that we are ourselves. And the big population of people that do listen to country music understands that they have their rights, because they are white, and black people don't really understand their rights and their wills on information, and gun control, population, all that stuff, you know, how to carry, how to carry. The most people in the world that do carry are the fair-skinned Caucasian people, you know, citizens that live in America, and we are normally not. If we do carry, it's not legal. Most times it's not. It is illegal, but we still do carry, and it's legal to us because we need to protect ourselves. But when it comes down to the actual makeup of this situation, I feel as though it had to be some kind of an MK Ultra situation, because, like, literally, he didn't, you know what was going to happen. No one knew what was going to happen. His brother didn't know what was going to happen. Even his videos for his brother, he didn't know. Like, you could tell he didn't know. So he had to be MK Ultra, or he could have been a scapegoat for the Islamic State to go ahead and just use him as an example for us to go and be distracted from what's actually going on. Yeah, or they can just use this to be prepare for what's going to happen when Islamic State does come over and start messing with our world, our universe. So I don't know, you guys. Let me know.